What is index in SQL Server? Hi, I am M. Asif Hussain from KnowHow Academy. In this video, I am going to guide you what is meant by an index in SQL. How is index used in SQL Server? One example of SQL Server. How to view your index that you have created in SQL Server. How to drop an index from SQL Server. So I am going to cover all these in my today's video. Before directly explaining it to you what is an index in SQL Server, let me define you or describe you the index word which we might have listened more frequently from our childhood. So whenever we are going to school, we used to carry a textbook with us, a guide with us. Whenever we go to college, we carry textbooks, we carry books with us, right? So if you carefully observe, as soon as we open the first 2 to 3 pages of our textbook, we have contents page, two to three pages of contents page will be there, or index page will be there. So what is the use of that index page? What is the use of that content pages that we have? What do we have in that content page? What do we have in that index page? We have the chapter names. We have the subtopic names. We have which page number is that topic there. No, we have all these things. Now, what is the use? When we already know that this is my topic, I can directly go into the topic and I can see the page, right? I can open up that particular page. But now the point is that without having an index page, without having a content page, we have to turn around our pages. We have to turn our pages multiple times in order to read what exactly the topic we want. It takes a lot of time. But now, if we have an index or if we have a content page, then we can easily get what we want, what we are searching for. For example, if I would like to see chapter number 14 and subtopic 14.2, then it is there in some 128th page. Then directly I will open my 128th page and I can open it up and I can start reading it out. So now what happens is that rather than you search for this 14th chapter 14.2 subtopic from page number 1, you can directly go to page number 128 by looking up to the page numbers that we have in our textbook. So now what happens? Your time that it is getting consumed when you are trying to search from starting the page, it takes a lot of time, right? So now that time is getting reduced by having an index page where you came to know that that particular topic is there in page number 128. So that is the use of index or content page that we have in textbooks. My dear viewers, the same application is there in SQL Server also. This index in SQL Server, it is also having the same use case. Whatever we want to search in SQL Server, if we have an index, it will improve the search performance rather than taking a lot of time. Okay, that is what index is. So now if I show it to you here, index, it is used to retrieve the data from the database more quickly. The point is that in the textbooks, in the content pages, in the index page that we have in textbooks, we can see that content page, right? We can see the index page, that's where we come to know what is the page number. But here in SQL Server, we cannot see the index that we have created. We cannot see that, okay? But the index, if we create it, it is created. The user cannot see the index created, okay? So it is used to improve the search operation. So now how to create an index? The syntax of creating an index is create index index name. So most probably the same way how we create the table, create table table name, on which table and what are the columns. In the same way, create index index name, on what table are we creating this index and for which columns in that table we are creating the index. Very simple. I am creating what? I am creating an index. What is that index name? And you are creating this index on which table? And in that table to which columns? As simple as such. Alright. So this is the simplest way of creating an index. Now, let me see how to create this index with one example. So here I am creating an index. You can give any name, but please make sure that we need to start the index name, whichever we are giving, with the IX. It indicates index, IX underscore D name. That's what I have taken. It's your choice. You can take Asif as your name. You can take Uday as your name. You can take Raj as your name. You can take anything. It's your choice, right? So index name is your choice, but start with IX, which indicates that is an index name. If you are writing a stored procedure, start with SP, which indicates that is a stored procedure. Okay, something in the same way. On which table I would like to create an index? In my database KnowHow, I have doctors table, so that's why I create on this doctors table. So in this doctors table, to which columns? So that column names also I have to create. So I have to write it, doctor name column, and we have something called as hospital column. So if I would like to show it to you here, select star from doctors table that we have. So if I execute it, we can see that we have doctor name and we have hospital. So that's what I'm taking here. I have taken the doctor's name column and the hospital column from a doctor's table to create my index. All right. So now let me create an index. So commands completed successfully. The index is successfully created. Okay. I have created the index. Now you might have a question. Sir, you have shown me how to create an index. Asif, you have shown me how to create an index, but can you please show me how to view my index? Okay. How to view? So now, as in front of you all, I have viewed or I have fetched the doctor's table. So the whole doctor's table, I have got it. That's where I have seen my doctor's table, the columns and the data that I have in the table. Now, how to view this index? So the way, the procedure is a bit different when we want to view an index. You know, we should not use select star there. Okay. We should not use select star there. We have to use SP underscore help index with the table name. Okay. So now let me show it to you. SP underscore help index. What is the table name? To which table did we create this particular index? We created for this doctor's table to the two columns, doctor name and hospital. Okay. If I execute it, we can see that for the two columns we have created doctor name and hospital, we have created the index. All right, so this is how you can view the index that you have created. You please do not bother what is this non-clustered, what is this clustered and all that. I'll explain it to you in my upcoming videos. Okay, we have created the index for two columns in the doctor's table, which is for the doctor name and hospital, that we got it here. So using the SP underscore help index, you can view your index that you have created. Okay, now if you want to drop the index that you have created, the very simple example, drop table, table name, how we used to drop the table, in the same way, drop index table name dot index name. Okay, you have to mention to which table you have created the index and what is the index name. So for this, I'll write an example. I am dropping my index, what, for which table? For doctor's table. So dot, what is my index name? My index name is IX underscore D name. That is my index name. So if I paste it here and if I click it on, commands completed successfully. Now the index that I have created for the doctor's name column and the hospital column, that is removed from my table. So if I execute it, we can see that doctor's name and hospital is not there. It got removed. That's where drop index comes into the picture. All right. So this is how you have to create the index. This is how you have to view the index. And if you want to remove the index, you can use this by using drop index in table name dot index name. So index, it is helping us in order to improve the search operations, right? In order to improve the search performance, I can call it as. So that it saves our time in order to see or fetch the record that we would like to, that we are searching for, all right? So thank you for choosing KnowHow Academy as your source for IT knowledge. We are always here to help you to navigate the tech world. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to reach out. It's been a pleasure sharing this information with you. Stay curious and keep learning.